terms of tradition, so that this idea of the truth about reality, these three learnings of wholesome conduct, what I call coming to composure in mind, body, and emotion, it's a funny term. We're the only school that says we don't teach it, clearly says we don't teach it. Some schools are a bit vague about that. Some of those dreams come from Nietzsche and are a bit vague about it. But we have nothing against meditation. The mind is deluded, and you're going to meditate. What's meditating? The deluded mind. So there's a little bit of a problem there that's always been seen. There's been a problem seen from the origin of tradition in that what's the objective? It's liberation. What's the recreate the unconditioned? It's always been seen as problematic. Originally, there was a pretty clear viewpoint that what's important about morality, cookie must, 7 years old, throws off your meditation. And then if your meditation is thrown off, you're never going to have the deep insight into reality. There really was this kind of three-step view, and it became very standard in tradition, and it's very problematic. It's one of the reasons that Dogen Honen, founder of Jodo-shu, all said Buddhism is not free art. Wholesome conduct, meditation, and insight. It's a little too mechanical. But if it seems independent, it's not necessarily a problem. And it comes to be in both Mahayana and Vajrayana, the state of mind and attitudes more than what you're doing. Whereas in the Theravada, it's still very important what you do. And there are